Well, tonight was the April 16th, 2019 County Council meeting, and we had a quality meeting with a lot of positive discussion. It didn't last long, but there were some key items on the agenda, and we started out with some proclamations and awards. And a group in this county who is doing a fantastic job is the Milltown Players in Pelzer. And we were able to bring them up tonight and congratulate them. They're going to a national tournament, per se, for acting, and they're just doing a fantastic job. They're bringing art and culture to the county. They're also driving economic development, because I know other folks from other counties are coming to see them. From there, we went into two proclamations that we actually did earlier at the Anderson Touchdown Club, and that was to recognize the academic and athletic achievements of two athletes here in Anderson. One is Darian Rencher from T.L. Hanna High School, and the second is Kendall Joseph from Belton Huntington Path. And these two guys, from all accounts, are just quality men who have succeeded on the field and off the field. They were part of the Clemson National Title Team, and there was a packed house at the Civic Center for them to receive their award for the Touchdown Club. But we made that official tonight at the County Council meeting. From there, we went in and heard from Steve Pellissier. He actually runs the Appalachian Council of Governments. If you're not familiar with that entity, it's basically an entity that brings together all the upstate counties and allows us to have an interface on projects with the federal government. And so we participate in it. We receive many grants from it for infrastructure, from the airport to roads to all numerous things. And every year Steve comes and gives us a report and basically says, hey, you're participating with us. Let us show you a return on investment. Let us show you the quality services and the things that we're able to provide. And it was a quality presentation. From there, Ms. Floyd did a commendation with Brian Richardson and his department and what they were doing at the old McCants facility. They have it looking very nice, and we're very hopeful that it will be somewhere that more people can use in the community, and it's already being utilized to a great extent with Meals on Wheels and the senior programs. After that, we went into third reading on three economic development projects. Some of them were routine of nature. We spoke about them in the past. It's joint industrial parks with Greenville. It's a level of paperwork, but it incentivizes companies. One thing of note is, and this was third reading, and I think it's up in the Powdersville area, but it's actually a company or individuals who are coming, and they're doing a spec building in Anderson County. Now, they're doing the spec building with their own money, total investors, but they're asking for economic development help like any other entity coming to the county. But that is a positive sign of our commercial and industrial market in Anderson, because a number of years ago we were doing the spec buildings,
and now, the last two we built were sold before we could get
The whole complex went,
right.
And so we're really seeing the benefits of the national economy. We're seeing the benefits of the efforts we put forth here locally, and those benefits are being recognized by investors who are willing to bring their own money. So that was a very encouraging project. From there, we went into second reading for some special source revenue credits. It was another economic development project in the county. And then two things of note from last county council meeting. We had a good amount of discussion about some zoning ordinances that involved people having commercial and personal property at their house. There was concerns that there were some very egregious scenarios in the county that had upset some citizens, because somebody had so much equipment at their house, they were running a business out of their house. And so naturally you want to look, what could we do about that so that we could help those citizens? But in all these efforts, we never want to overreach where we're creating an unintended consequences or a cumbersome ordinance that would disproportionately or negatively affect citizens who are doing the right thing. So with council members showing concern about this ordinance, we actually asked for it to be voted and sent to the Planning Commission. And that was key, because the planning commissioners actually go to training and go to educational courses on the best way to handle these. And we wanted to send it to them to get their recommendation. Ultimately, it would have to come back to council. I didn't see that there was a lot of favorable treatment to it as it was currently presented, but we'll see what they come back with. And I know council wants to move forward to help in the egregious scenarios, but we'll be very careful to make sure that we don't unintentionally catch someone who's doing the right thing. From there, we accepted three roads into county inventory, and typical, we made sure those roads met certain requirements. County staff went over those roads, and we received a recommendation from the administrator. We then received some requests for council, and then each council member, like always, ended the night with some commentary about what's going on in their district, and some commentary about what they enjoyed seeing in the county or any concerns. And everything was very routine of nature. We had one citizen's comment, and it was some general observations about the county. But overall, everything was positive. And so next county council meeting, we expect the budget to be coming out.
And that's so going to be the major topic from here on out, right?
From here on out. And so we'll be talking about it at the county council meetings, but we'll also be holding what we call budget hearings or budget workshops. And these will be basically extra county council meetings where we can spend more time delving in to the different line items presented by departments, figuring out how they affect the different districts, figuring out how they help us move forward on the priorities that constituents have communicated to us and that council wants to move as a body. So very important stuff coming up. It'll be lasting over a couple of months. I encourage anybody to reach out at any time if they have any questions about the process, or if they have any concerns, or if they just have some input that they want to put forth in that process. So we always appreciate that.